Hi, my name's Aaron. I'm a producer with HLN News Now, and I'm going to make Bruno. All right, as you can see, we've got our oranges peeled. They're ready to go. The next step is put them in the plastic bag. All right, here's the plastic bag. Here are the oranges. You have to mash it all up. That is kind of what we're left with. Let's go ahead and add our water here. All right, so we've got our mixture here. Next thing we want to do is take it over here to the sink and put it in the hot water. That's going to help kickstart the fermentation process. We're going to leave it here for a little bit. We'll come back and check on it. We're going to wrap it up in this towel. Reason why? Most important thing here, we've got to hide it from the guards. So make sure we have a good hiding place. Obviously, this is a kitchen, not a prison cell. So you can imagine where they can hide things. This is also called toilet wine. Sometimes they hide it in the toilet. We are gonna hide this in a drawer. And how long does it have to stay there? A couple of days. All right, time to check our concoction. Let's take a look here. All right, let's pull it out here. So we've got to feed it. And what does yeast like to eat? Well, I know yeast likes to eat sugar, but I didn't know it liked to eat ketchup.
Ketchup, sugar.
First, our ketchup. Go ahead and mix this up a little bit. And now we need to put the sugar in it. That's where these come in. So here we go. So we're giving it another warm bath. A little wrap here. That looks a little puffy. Might have some fermentation going on. Oh yeah. What happens actually is when the fermentation process starts, gases build up and you get a little air in the bag. So that's kind of what we have right now. All right, so we've got our mash here. We've got a lot of juice. This has been fermenting for several days now. Definitely smells like there's some alcoholic something going on in there. But what we want to do now is strain it all out. Okay, so we've got it strained out. It's here. Come take a look at it right here in this pot. There's still some chunky stuff in it. I'm going to go one step further and strain it again with some cheesecloth. It smells kind of stale fruit. A little bit like alcohol. Nothing left to do but to actually try it. Cheers. It's pretty sweet, like very syrupy sweet. There's definitely alcohol in it. And, but there's some like saltiness to it too. I'm not sure what that is. All I can say is that if you had to drink it and you're trying to get a buzz in jail or prison, it's probably okay. But if you wanna drink this on a daily basis, I would not recommend it.